In this video, I'll be conducting t-tests for one sample mean based on the built-in R dataset cars. Running it shows that it has two variables, speed and distance. Suppose we're only interested in speed and want to test if the true mean speed differs significantly from 16.8. We can assign the speed variable to x by typing x equals cars $speed. I'm going to press Ctrl L to clear the console and then run this line 6. To generate the t-test output for the data, we use t.test. Then the data, which we assign to x, comma, mu equals 16.8, the hypothesized value. On running that, we have this one sample t-test output. The sample mean is 15.4. By default, t.test generates a 95% confidence interval for the data. It tells us the alternative hypothesis is that the true mean is not equal to the hypothesized value. The test statistic is given here. Then the degrees of freedom for the test, n-1. And finally, the p-value. Note that the p-value generated by default is for the two-tailed or two-sided test. Recall that we reject the null hypothesis when the p-value is less than the specified significance level alpha. In this case, at alpha equals 0.05, we will fail to reject the null hypothesis because this p-value is greater than 0.05. This means the result is not significant or there is no significant effect. In other words, there is insufficient evidence to conclude that the true mean speed significantly differs from 16.8. We could also use the confidence interval to draw the same conclusion. Since the 95% confidence interval includes 16.8, we cannot reject the null hypothesis, which states that the true mean is 16.8. Now, suppose we want a 99% confidence interval in the output rather than a 95. We can add the argument conf.level or simply conf equals 0.99. Running that shows the output with 99% confidence interval here. Note that the only difference compared to the previous output is the 99% confidence interval. Everything else is the same. Next, let's consider one-sided or directional tests. Suppose we want to test if the true mean is less than 16.8. This would be a lower-tailed or left-tailed test, and it requires we add alternative or simply alt equals less in quotes. On running that, we have this output. You can see that the alternative hypothesis now states that the true mean is less than 16.8. Note that the test statistic has not changed from the preceding output. However, the p-value for this one-sided result is exactly half of that of the two-sided result. In essence, since the t-statistic is negative and we're conducting a left-tailed test, we could have divided the two-tailed p-value by 2 to obtain the corresponding left-tailed p-value. For this lower-tailed result, since the p-value is less than 0.05, we will reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the true mean is less than 16.8. Note also that the 95% confidence interval goes from negative infinity to 16.65, which does not capture 16.8. This also suggests we should reject the null hypothesis or the result is significant. Finally, let's consider a right or upper-tailed case where the hypothesized mean is 14.3. The alternative hypothesis would be mu greater than 14.3. I will change the alternative in the t-test function to greater here and run. Oh no, the output is wrong. I forgot to change mu to 14.3. I'm going to change it now and rerun. And here is the correct output. It states the alternative hypothesis is that the true mean is greater than 14.3. The t-stat is positive and the p-value is greater than 0.05. suggesting that we should fail to reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.05. However, we will reject the null at alpha equals 0.1, since this p-value is less than 0.1. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.